Hi guys, thanks for joining me again. If you're new to my channel, my name is Anne, and on my channel, I review foreign international content. And once in a while, we get one of those shows that definitely is international. And Emily in Paris, I believe, is one of those, right? So it's Hollywood made, which we get. By the way, executive producer is the same guy who does Sex in the City, Darren Star, which is very, very evident when you watch Emily in Paris. For some of you who don't know what Emily in Paris is, Emily is an American. She's sent to Paris to a company that now is working with an American company. So they're kind of merging together, and she is living her best life being in Paris and interacting with French people who, let me just say, I don't know, but they make French people come off like so, you know, nose up in the air, like uppity and like don't care for Americans. I don't know, but you can tell me, right? But anyway, so in season one, that's what she does. She goes, she's trying to acclimate, learn French, try to make friends. She's got a very a serious, kind of a mean boss in Sylvia. And then she's got her friends who she works with that are really a lot of fun. And then obviously they introduce the character of Gabriel, who is a chef who in season one we thought he was leaving because he could not find financing for a restaurant, but ends up getting financing and is staying. Unfortunately, at that point, she had hooked up with him. She thought, oh, I just sleep with him. I'll never see him. He's going to Notre Dame anyway. Who cares? And then, oh, you're not going? And then her good friend, who she made in Paris, Camille, also used to date Gabrielle, and she's still in love with him. So let's just say, Emily is stuck in one of those like love triangle, a mess, right? And then we come to season two, and I have to say, let's start off the bat with the good, right? The fashion, oh, it's so Sex in the City worthy, right? All the clothing they put on her, oh my God, it's like going shopping with your eyes, just watching everything she's wearing. By the way, it made me wonder, is it that all French people dress like that, or is it the thought of what an American, you know how Americans romanticizes France, you know, the city of love, you know, like Alfie talked about it in the show. And I'm like, I don't think all French women dress up like, ooh, we're going to a party. But this, I feel like it's that, you know, fantasy that all Americans have. If I go to Paris, I want to wear the best clothes, and I want to go eat in all the best places, and I want to go to all those beautiful sites. Oh, like the Saint-Tropez when she went on vacation. That is exactly, I think, what most Americans are like. Yep, I want to dress like that, and I want to go to the vacation spot, and I want to look as good as she does, right? But I have to say, it's beautifully shot, and it's almost like just eye candy for your eyes for days, from the buildings of France, you know, Eiffel Tower and everything else, to Saint-Tropez, to all the different shots of Paris, the markets, you know, the outside markets and the food. I mean, it's just, ooh, it's, if you don't care for the storyline, you could definitely just watch it for the eye candy, because this is so much. It makes you so happy from, like I said, the fashion and the location. Ooh, ooh la la, like the French say. Just excellent, right? And then obviously in season two, and I don't know about you, you can tell me when you watch it, it felt like the whole Gabrielle, Emily love story was kind of being prolonged and prolonged. And then obviously they put in Alfie. Woo, Alfie, my chocolate British brother. Woo, he is so handsome, oh my. He's really good. Okay, Emily. Emily is down with the swirl. And so she's dating this British guy, and it's almost like she's trying to get over Gabrielle. But it was almost like the silent thing that we, all the viewers and everybody else knows, that her and Gabrielle are not over. he's trying to get over her by being with Camille, and I don't even feel like they have chemistry. And then he is with Alfie over here, who they're learning French together, but I'm like, you always, at the back of your mind, you always have Gabrielle, right? Because clearly she was like, when I slept with him, that was life-changing, right? And he felt the same way, so I'm like, what's the problem here? Like, you guys should get together and stop dragging Camille and Alfie in the middle of all it, of all that, right? So clearly there'll be a season three. So I'm hoping maybe we'll wrap this up, right? And by the way, I love her friend Mindy. Oh, just trying to make it with her music and that one song when she does BTS. Oh, that was so much fun. That Mindy can sing. I so love her, and I love her love interest in season two. So, so cute. But then I was gonna finish off with Sylvia. I'm sorry. Sylvia is like, we get it. You don't like Americans at all, okay? But you agree to work with an American company, and you don't wanna acclimate a little bit of the American way. I mean, if we're investing, we're gonna have some say in how the company is run. And you can tell how she just has a hard time. I love that Kate Walsh this time comes to Paris and she's like, what do you mean you guys start work at 11, right? Like, as Americans, that's like, are you kidding me? That's half the day's over. We're about to go to lunch. You're just showing up to work. How is that possible, right? And I get it. The European lifestyle may be a little bit slow. But I was like, that's a little bit unreasonable that any company would accept another company but don't want to change. Like, how do you get that, you know? And then, you know, the fact that she's just setting the American company up to fail, I was like, I don't know. So that part, I don't know if I care too much for it, but we'll see in season three, maybe we finally get that compromise. Yes, we don't want to come to France and just shove American culture and everything in there. We know Americans love to do that to everybody's culture. On the other hand, there's gotta be a, you know, give and take. And I felt like Sylvia is like, no American, don't care for the American. No, no, right? Like, I was just like, come on, Sylvia, come on. And then the fact that some of your deals were made because of who you slept with. Sylvia, I don't know if I like you. But anyway, I have to say, season two, if I was to give it a rating, maybe a 7 out of 10. I would have loved the Gabrielle Emily's relationship to proceed a little more faster. I felt as far as the storyline, that was a little slow, but they definitely kept us entertained with the fashion and the locations. I mean, like I said, it's eye candy for your eyes, for locations and what she's wearing. It's really fantastic storyline. It's okay, but I'll still watch season three when it comes because I love it. But I did feel like it was a little slow compared to season one. What do you think? Have you watched? Do you love it? Let me know. If you do like the video, please do give me a like, subscribe. It does help to support my channel. And I'll see you again when I'm reviewing another excellent foreign international show. Deuces.